had conferred upon him licentiate in theology. He would continue to study and earn a Master of Arts from Episcopal Divinity School, a Master of Sacred Theology from Yale Divinity, and a PhD from King's College, University of London, three academies with international reputation. Not bad for a Ghanaian boy with no formal secondary school education. Reputation as a theologian and theological educator. Our candidate worked tirelessly to improve the quality of theological education in West Africa. St. Nicholas Seminary, where he has served as a lector, sub-rector, coordinator, and eventually dean, became a force to reckon with in West Africa. Like Trinity, St. Nicholas has helped shape the lives of students, who in turn shape the lives of thousands of people who live in places we've never heard of, who assist people we've never met, and who speak languages we do not understand, all in the name of Jesus Christ, whom we seek to serve as disciples. I visited our candidate when he was dean at St. Nicholas and was immediately impressed with the improved quality of the library and the work on technology, which has opened up new vistas of possibilities for schools formerly reliant on the hand-me-down libraries of retired and deceased clergy from the West. Chancellor, I'd like to present a man who's known as a noted ecumenicist. Well, it is my view that we in Toronto, and we live in the most multicultural city in the world, in my view, we live in an ecumenical wasteland. Our candidate lives in a country where that luxury cannot be taken for granted. The Anglican Consultative Council has made him a consultant at Anglican Baptist International Forum. He's participated in consultations on theological anthropology as a member of the Faith and Order Commission of the World Council of Churches and has served as an executive member of Anglican Global and Ecumenicism at Episcopal Divinity. He has a passion for ecumenical work, which easily could serve as an example to many of us. As much as we might like to believe otherwise, Anglicans do not have an exclusive corner on Christianity. Am I to present a man who is an author? This candidate has authored, among other publications, The Contextualization of Anglicanism to West Africa, The Anglican Covenant, an African Perspective, Ministerial Formation and Theological Education in Ghana, Perspectives and Challenges, and African Traditional Religion, among others. He is noted for incorporating into his work sound theology, a Catholic outlook, and a passion for the global Anglican communion, which, by the way, is found in no less than 164 countries in the world. We are the Avis of Christian churches. The Roman Catholics are the Hertz, we're the Avis. And he's an advocate for healing and reconciliation within our somewhat fractured communion. Chancellor, I present a man noted for his courage. It may not have escaped the attention of this academy that in the words of one of his nominators of this candidate, quote, some African bishops, especially those of the evangelical Anglican tradition of East Africa, have required an international reputation for hostility to any positive view of gay sexuality, end quote. This candidate takes a much more balanced and open view, and as a result has endured significant condemnation from his colleagues. It is the mark of a courageous person that they do not bend to peer pressure, but express what they believe to be true, despite the opposition they may endure. Courage is never an easy journey. Am I to present a man chosen bishop in the church? Having served with distinction in a number of parishes in Ghana and London, England, our candidate was elected bishop of the Diocese of Cape Coast. The cathedral there is within walking distance of the so-called slave castles, where Africans were rounded up by slave traders, would be stored for shipping across the Atlantic to the Caribbean, the United States, and to Canada. The slave castle, to use an academic term, gave me the willies as I visited there, as I could almost hear the cries of the pain of those who were there, of people captured by the evil of slavery, an evil sadly still not yet eradicated from human. human activity today. There he is responsible for leading a large, growing, and vibrant diocese filled not only with parishes, but schools and seminary and other institutions. The short time I was there, I was impressed with the passion, the faith, the joy, and the witness of a church not afraid to take a strong stance in the name of Jesus Christ, not ashamed to recognize and counter its checkered colonial past, and not afraid to speak truth to power. Berkeley Divinity Seminary in Yale, in recognition of his, quote, commitment to the gospel as it has been shared through the Anglican tradition, his passion for work of preparing men and women for service in the church, and his vision of an Anglican communion united in ministry and mission, end quote, has already awarded this candidate an honorary degree. And so, Mr. Chancellor, I remain confused about the man I am to present to you today, but I am not at all confused that the Right Reverend Dr. Victor Reginald Atta Baffoe, theologian, academic, educator, ecumenicist, author, courageous bishop, and disciple of Jesus Christ, is a worthy recipient from the University of Trinity College, which he credits as having an enormous influence shaping and broadening his life, the degree Doctor of Divinity honoris causa.
In Reverend Doctor, in Divinitate, in Nomen Patris,